Okay, here's one that I've done a first impression of, but I think it's just a... I think it's just a pretty short game, so I am just looking for something real quick I can get through, so... Let's see... That is true. A really long neck. Look at that neck.
Oh, the physical sensation. Pain? I'm alive? That's odd. I don't feel alive. What's going on? I have no memories of anything before this point in time. My mind is tabula rasa. Yet, I have a language. I seem to be in some laboratory of sorts. Maybe I can find out what happened if I look around.
Okay, first things first. Oh, shoot. I can't do anything about the background audio. I think I brought that up when I did a first impression of this, but whatever.
A torture device turned into a strange machine. What kind of place is this?
Okay.
My very first memory is waking up on this thing. Before that, nothing. I wonder what I am.
Alright. Let's pick this up.
There's a handwritten note here. Maybe it can shed some light on my situation.
Okay. There's with shaky hands and heavy heartbeats. I gather before me the instruments of my last desperate attempt. Find myself on the threshold of my toils. A turning point for I should fail tonight. Blah blah blah. Life is for maze. Belladonna. Okay, so this is the reanimated wife. Okay. Can I pick that? Is that a tool? Okay.
There's a screwdriver in this toolbox. Better take it.
All right, wonderful.
A human skull or a paperweight. Now is not the time.
Okay.
Books. A lot of natural philosophy and chemistry. Something by an M.W. Shelley.
Yep.
It's a brain in a jar. I wonder what it's thinking.
Bone saws, what it's thinking.
Ooh, surgical tools. Shiny.
Okay.
I have no idea what's inside of this, but it glows.
Alright. Gargoyle.
That is one ugly gargoyle. Looks like a George to me. The door won't budge. It seems to be barred from the other side. I might be able to unscrew these hinges, though.
So it's actually been a long time since I...
The screws on these hinges are rusty and stuck.
So I don't remember.
I need some
lubricant
to loosen them up. With such a multitude of jars and bottles, at least one must have some sort of oil in it. This oil looks expensive. Let's waste it.
Okay.
I smeared some oil on the rusty screws. That should loosen them up. I'm free.
Sort of.
Another piece of paper. This was written long before the last one.
Doo-doo, work is going great. Okay. Alright. Belladonna, seeing another man. Like I said, I'm just looking for something to chillax right here, not really reading through everything. Whatever.
There's a long stick here. Perhaps it was used to try to chase away rats when trying to sleep. It looks like someone has been sleeping quite a lot in this sorry excuse for a bed, and it was hardly the suit of armor. But why would someone choose to sleep down here?
Well, let's go look at the armor.
What a dedicated knight to guard a damp dungeon like this. Maybe he was demoted. Maybe he likes the dark. Maybe he's secretly a poet. I bet his name is Roland.
Roland. Alright.
More writings from the Lonely Doctor.
Cursed by miserable existence. To do all I can do is work. Okay, so I am betting this guy probably murdered his wife, then it tried reanimating her. This is where I got stuck last time.
Another locked door. Let's take a peek through.
Is that... yeah, there's some way...
The stick is long enough to reach the key, but how will I grab it? I'm content with the length of this stick.
Yeah, there's something I do to the stick. Okay. So, I am straight up cheating. I have the walkthrough up here, but this game is in full screen, and it looks like it does not like alt-tabbing or anything, so I'm gonna quickly pause the recording here for a sec. Okay. I missed something way back here. Can you speed up? Run. And stay on the steps, please. Lady. Okay, way back here, there is a magnet. Alright, now it all makes sense. Aha!
I love magnets.
How do they work? That, I think, is what I missed the first time I've tried this.
Another locked door. Let's take a peek through.
Doo-doo.
Look, I can attach the magnet to the end of this stick.
Ba-ba.
Another locked door. Let's take a peek through.
Okay.
Let's hope this works. Aha! Just as planned.
Okay.
I got the basement key.
Yeah, that stick could be useful. I mean, where to go? Journal page.
More letters. Has he figured it out yet?
Alright, I see now that my suspicions have been well grounded, albeit aimed in the wrong direction. Belladonna is not seeing another man, she's seeing a woman. Bum bum bum. I'm convinced that must be the map maid, Claire, or whatever her name might be. She and Belladonna are up to something, I'm sure of it. And to think of all the hours I'm stuck down here, caught up in my dreadful work, leaving them free to roam and left to their own devices upstairs. Of course they have found each other. Only living things in this whole castle besides me are... and my week-long rabbits? Okay. Week-long rabbits. You don't measure length in time. Does he mean week-old rabbits? Or whatever. They have it all figured out. When I come up at night, they act all innocent, keeping their mutual secret for me as a playful game. But as soon as I descend to the laboratory, they're in each other's arms again. But what can I do? The progression of events are beyond my control. Just like my work, I slave away in my ghoulish endeavor, making progress every hour, whatever. Alright, this one I'm actually reading the entire thing, but whatever. Blah blah blah, but never getting anywhere. It's supposed to be Belladonna is slipping away from me and further and further every night. So, are we the maid, or are we playing as the wife, or some conglomeration of both? Should I confront them, storm over there, hoping to catch the two of them in the act? Take back the life that was mine? The wife that was mine? No. I have no reason for my solicitation, no evidence whatsoever, merely a thought stuck in my brain refusing to leave, so I remain passive, as always, and each day is more... one more where I am unable to take action, unable to change my wretched situation.
Nothing happens.
Alright, let's take the
gears. A couple of cogwheels on the floor. They must have fallen off the mechanism when the door slammed shut. I wonder if I can put them back.
Okay.
What a strange door. No handle or keyhole. It seems to have some sort of opening mechanism. Oh, I know. It's a secret entrance hidden behind a bookshelf. Only, I'm on the other side of it and see only the back of the shelf. Not yet.
Okay, I gotta get an order then. Bam.
Not yet.
Top one?
Not yet.
What? There. Mortar and pestle.
It's a mortar. And a pestle, too. They seem to belong here, but I'll remember where they are in case I need them another time.
So, I'm confused. Is the stick the mortar and the bowl the pestle, or is that backwards? You know, I've known of mortar and pestle for a while, but I guess I never really actually sat back and thought which one was which.
A big and heavy candlestick. It looks like there used to be two of them. The label says Dr. Wolfram von Trauerschloss. So this is the man who brings the dead back to life. He looks as though he would have been handsome once. It's warm. I haven't realized until now just how cold my body is. The doctor is losing it. He's just scribbling down nonsense by now. What will he do if he ever acts on his wild suspicions?
It is clear to me what I must do. I am not convinced beyond reasonable doubt that my wife is unfaithful. They still hide it very well, her and that housemaid. Much of mine tells me there's no expert explanation. Ponder the situation. To fully concentrate on the puzzles, that hand is like my thoughts creeping back to my wife and her new lover. Belladonna herself is a person who I want back into my life, so I cannot punish her. Leaves her younger, her lover, the young maid. She is unimportant, and it is she that must go. Fire her. Blah, blah, blah. No, it is clear to me what I must do. I must get rid of the maid for good. A lot of plants and herbs. Deadly nightshade. Oh, okay. So, you're going to poison her to death using something like a rare, or, well, technically nightshade isn't really even that rare. Of course, this is deadly nightshade, so that might be something completely different. And you're going to expect, like, the people not to realize who knows how to do this, but whatever. I think he has reanimated the body there, but... whatever. Atropa Belladonna. Oh, so that's where it gets the name Belladonna. It's a trick. Alright, and there is one right here.
This story is so sad. I don't even know if I want to read this one.
My wife took the waiver maid's death harder than I had expected, further confirming my suspicions that they were indeed having a secretive love affair. She's passionate and irrational, raging all day and crying all night. Where a few months ago the cold shroud of silence lay over our house, now there is the wailing shrieks of bedlam. One should think that she would listen, be used to dealing with the grief of lost loved ones by now. Oh, has he done this before? However, in all sincerity, I don't believe she was ever as affected by the death of our only son as I was. Also suspected she might have guessed I had something to do with her love's demise. If she wouldn't talk to me before, now she yells and barks at my every movement. In the soundtrack, is there like some weird, like beeping sound or something? Whatever. Hardly leave my laboratory, but all the while she prowls. Yep. What happened to the love we shared when we married? We were going to have children. Back to the way things were before. Okay, I'm running out of spots, although I have to assume that these get filled with somethings. Bowl.
A beautiful china bowl. It looks hand-painted. The name on the plaque is Lucas von Trauerschloss. This must be the ashes of Wolfram's son.
Alright.
A dead body. It's the body of Dr. von Trauerschloss. He's dead. And what's more, he's been murdered. But who could have done this?
There must be some clues around.
The missing candlestick. And it seems to be the murder weapon. There's a letter clutched in his hand. His final words? Or a clue left by the killer?
Over the course of a sleepless night, I'm playing this pretty late at night, so I'm kinda tired, but I just had this urge to just play something short and sweet, and yeah, just deal with it. Take action. The troublesome maid out of the way. But I have one idea, one that kept me up. I've come very far with my research. Ooh, so is it his wife's brain in the jar, or is it the maid's? The creation is perfectly functioning in response to stimuli, just as if it were truly alive, but there's a spark of will seems to be missing. With clockwork parts, okay. Unhealed bodily damage. The integrity of her visage. So basically trying to make sure that she looks the same. Oh, hoo-hoo. So here he has decided to...
This letter is signed Belladonna. I've been waiting to hear the other side of this story.
Say it would be as it is. Alright. Get a flat in Vienna. Let's go live in your family's old castle. Although living in an old castle would be cool, but it is just far too horror movie tropey. It's like, hey, let's go live in a castle. No way this could turn out poorly. All right, so So she's... Oh, okay, so this must be the lady of the house. This must be the doctor. And down here would be more of that. And then over here, who knows? More grog grills.
It's an old clock. Tick, tock, tick, tock.
I think there's an achievement if you name all the gargoyles.
Those are a lot of gargoyles. Leupold, Brunhilde, Arthur, Maya, Lena, Ismildur, Ether, and Yosef. In that order.
Alright, I wonder if there's like a... thing if you memorize the names.
One more Belladonna letter. Let's read about this Clara figure.
Is that the maid? Several chambermaids. Yep. Just another servant of many. Time following the death of Lucas is hazy and unclear. As more of the staff left the castle to seek employment elsewhere, there was less and less reason for us to stay, and the household was quickly decimated. Decimated technically refers to an old, like, Roman legion thing, where if a unit misbehaved, they would randomly kill off 10%. That's why, you know, deci, which is, you know, means 10 or 10% or whatever. So, every time I see it now, I know most people use it, like, where you would use, like, annihilated or obliterated or destroyed or whatever. But, yeah, whatever. But all of this, young Clara never left my side, and she gradually shouldered more and more of the household responsibilities, making it her task to take care of me and the nurse me through my melancholy. It was her loyalty and industriousness when everyone else had left that finally brought me back from my condition, and indeed, her love. As I now sit down to write this, which is, my mouth is getting dry here, so too much reading. Papa, happy days to I've no incentive whatsoever to uphold convention and norms when this house has become too. Reap any concrete benefits from near, neither financial nor societal. I'm already adopting her adorable habit of naming inanimate objects. Dun dun dun. So, are we Belladonna or are we Clara? It's not quite ours, however. Wolfen still lurks like a ghoul downstairs and occasionally emerges and spends the night up here with me. We may have declared him mad and sent off to an institution. Alright. Interesting. Get the milk.
There's a bottle of milk out here. I wonder how long it's been here. At any rate, it's frozen completely solid. No wonder in this cold. This must be the family cemetery. Yet, baby Lucas rests in an urn in the dining room. Why is that? It says, Snowflake the pet cat. How cute. The stone is so old and the name is worn off.
Okay, what's going on there?
A note.
Great God! Why did I not then expire? If you like instructions, Oh, this one's another one from Belladonna. It was mere days ago. Headaches, tiredness. Hey, she was there, lifeless and inanimate, from across the bed.
tombstone says Clara Stieber. This must be the grave of the wonderful maid I've heard so much about. I can't help but notice that it's been emptied.
Ooh, that greenhouse. Ooh, there's more there. Let's see if there's...
Two statues of angels. It seems a bit paradoxical to create statues depicting something that's supposed to be immaterial. Let's call them Justifer and Phi.
Okay, boxes.
Yes, those are indeed boxes.
Why, thank you. Just, confirming my suspicion.
More letters. Can someone tell me what happened to poor Clara?
Well, she gets murdered. Mysterious circumstances, you don't say. Somehow ingested something that made her sick, but what? And from that line of thought, well, so, she knows her name is Belladonna, and she knows that Belladonna is a type of poison. Lost track of the details. Okay, what I'm thinking is that the doctor was going to resurrect Clara, but then the wife found out that Clara was poisoned by him, and then while after he like flipped the switch or something, she murdered him. So... That is my bet. Plantu.
A plant, a natural object, standing in a pot, a man-made object. The plant can consume nutrition and grow bigger, and the pot can't. Neither of them can think. So what about me, then? I can think, I know that. But am I natural or man-made?
Yes.
This lantern might prove to be the very first thing that actually manages to shed some light on my situation. I'll keep it.
Ba-bam!
Nothing inside. It's a large tree. Looks very peaceful. Couldn't I have been reincarnated into one of those instead of being forced back into this mess? Belladonna. This little plant has caused a lot of trouble. For a flower, it's not particularly beautiful, but for a murder weapon, it sure is.
Quite a beautiful murder weapon, I might say. Okay, that's everything in here. I think I'm full of quest items here. I really wish I could do something about the audio balance. I just turned down the background music a little bit. Oh, sorry. To the study. I think the living room would be a bit ironic right here. Journal page.
The doctor's handwriting. I know it well by now.
Months have passed, and I must indeed conclude that the procedure was a success. The new Belladonna is certainly calmer, friendlier, and more docile. She generally keeps me company in the laboratory nowadays, and she is polite and pleasant in everything she does. I'm tempted to describe her demeanor as lobotomized, but no. When I ask her questions, she will answer in a clear and articulated voice. She is responsive to all kinds of stimuli. Verily, I've gotten all I could ask for. The troublesome maid is gone, and Belladonna is back with me. Okay, so he did kill and then resurrect his Belladonna. So I'm guessing this must be Clara, or Clara, who he also resurrected for some reason. And then the wife was like must have had some of her memories returned to her, I'm guessing. All right. No child giggles in these halls, but our research is proceeding. Oh, so he probably resurrected Clara as a way to kind of like make a surrogate daughter. Okay, that's weird. And weird. unliving condition. The household cat, black beast, and once Belladonna's loving pet, has gained a great mistrust for the latter's new form. Okay, so finished up all of his. Oh, geez, clipping right along here.
Look, a perfect sphere. Let's see if I can get two parallel lines to intersect. I should sit down and write a story. But with all these journals and diary pages lying around, seems like I already may have. That's a lot of books. Imagine you had books filled with every possible combination of letters. I wonder how much room they would take. There's a finite amount of letters, but unless we acknowledge a maximum length of a word, there would still be an infinite number of combinations, and the library would have to be infinitely large.
Yeah.
Look at all these old toys. Wind-up dolls, music boxes, and mechanical trains all around. I think this used to be a private hobby of the eccentric Dr. Wolfram's, before he got into the whole corpse business.
Okay, any interesting toys I can take? Alright, I thought that
another
was
portrait.
Button or something.
Says her name is Franziska Canosa, an old relative, no doubt. But I wonder how she relates to the von Trauerschloss family. I'm not going near that horrible cat. I'll have to get rid of it somehow if I want to proceed.
Wow.
I'm not going near that horrible cat. I'm not going near that.
Okay, frozen milk?
Cats like milk, that is true. But this milk is frozen solid. I have to thaw it before I can do anything with it.
Okay.
Nothing happens. I need something.
Oh, the fireplace in the other room. First, we gotta check out the living room.
Look, a perfect.
Ooh.
A stuffed raven atop a bust of Pallas Athena. What a cheerful decoration. Let's call them Annabelle and Dupin. Another journal page. This one has drops of blood on it.
Belladonna, must think, remember. Add fingers. Write words. Agreed, hate. Oh, so this is the lobotomy. So this goes Belladonna, Belladonna, Belladonna. Then there's one more procedure Belladonna, and this is the post procedure Belladonna, so it's kind of like a goes around, and then this one, what is up with me today? This one must be for Clara at some point.
This room looks completely abandoned. I suppose this is what happens when you're down to a skeleton crew of only one maid, no matter how fantastic she is. This room looks completely abandoned.
Yep. She is kind of, talking
about the completely abandoned.
Maid.
It's snowing outside. It's snowing outside. I have no concept of the current year, season, or even geographical location.
Okay.
I'll let it stand by the fire for a while. It's thawed. The milk is now in liquid form.
Alright, put it in the bowl.
The milk pours easily.
Let's go, take care of that cat. Well, actually, I think I need to use this on the mortar and pestle so long as I'm in here.
Let's grind this plant into powder.
Bam! Let's kill the cat!
Is this how Clara died?
Ooh, we do kill the cat.
Yes, this should put an end to the grim reign of this beast. Look, it's a key, and it has a funny tassel attached to it. No wonder the cat wanted to play with it. The animal must have managed to steal a key somehow.
Okay.
This is strange. This is Belladonna's signature, but the handwriting is just wrong.
I write to exercise my brain, and that my thoughts become more firm and solid if I force myself to put them down on paper. Okay. No memory how long I have been this way, a walking corpse. Yeah, the handwriting is a little different. All of an obedient wife, a beautiful Galatia, that Galatia? Don't know that word. These notes are the century of my universe. Alright, it doesn't know. He has no idea. Slowly, secretly, meticulously, putting my consciousness out of a black void. Beginning to think again was horrible in many ways, worse than the state of blissful ignorance. Cutting it myself on the sharp pen once, not being able to prevent the blood flow. Surely Wolfram would notice the blood on my hands. I get suspicious, but no, self-absorbed fool, merely stitch me up and let me go. The monster has other plans.
Thaw the milk, grind the leaves, poison the cat. That was a lot of work to inspect this rather uninteresting ladder. The door is locked.
The way is
shut. That makes no sense.
It worked before, what do you mean? Oh, I'm dating myself. That was the old AOL Instant Messenger door sound effect. Oh, for people who actually know what that is. Oh my god. As my consciousness grew stronger, so does my hatred for my husband. In the corner there, I will stand for the rest of the day. Still as a statue, silent as death. I am a living decoration, breathing statue of flesh. His wind-up toy bride. Memorize every step he takes, every note he writes down, every tiny detail of his ghoulish discovery. If only he knew how fast I am learning. Explaining his scientific work aloud. I'm a golem, following orders. Alright. Looks like we're clipping right along. Whoa.
That's a big wardrobe. Bet you could hide a corpse in there. Actually, I better not open it and check.
That's a big wardrobe.
Bet you could... The mirror is completely shattered. I think someone in here didn't really like their reflection. Let's take a look inside. Coils of rope. I wonder why we're keeping rope in the bedroom. The lid is shaped like a heart and has a tiny keyhole. Whatever's inside must be very precious.
It's her brain.
Nothing happened.
Oh, okay. Oh.
A note.
Failure. The attempt was a failure. I cannot lure my lover back into her deceased corpse. All my preparations are vain and all alone now. No one to turn my key.
Is she dead? She doesn't move a muscle, yet she sits upright. She's like a mannequin of human flesh. At least the view is nice from up here.
Okay.
That won't work. That makes no sense.
Okay, where to now?
That's a big wardrobe. I bet you could hide a corpse in. That won't work.
They are going to be absolute jerks if they actually put something down here where it's covered up by their own frickin' thing.
Another portrait. It says her name is Francisca Canosa, an old relative, no doubt. But I wonder how she relates. I should sit down and... That's a lot of books. Imagine you had books filled with every possible combination of...
Okay... Some with the body.
There's something in his pocket. It's a small, delicate key. He kept it in the pocket closest to his heart. I wonder what it unlocks.
Bam. Wish you could, like, double click to make her walk a little faster, but whatever. I suppose she has no dash. Although, I will have to say to the artist, I mean, obviously the art is a little, it's passable, but it's, you know, definitely stylized, but a little janky, not bad though. But as far as character design, this is like a really awesome design, I do have to say. It's a little weird, but it's straight to the point. I mean, it's definitely a very good take on the whole Frankenstein type thing, so I think that's probably the reason why I even bothered picking up the game, is this is, like, really cool, like, this little Halo thing going on there. I don't know, I think it's actually a pretty good design. So, execution, maybe a couple points off for your execution, but the idea behind it is pretty cool. Like, these little spikies coming off her hands, that's pretty cool, too. Not to, you know, pick on someone for not being top-tier artist. I do think the artistic inspiration is good. But yeah, they don't even have, like, any shadows or any... Or they have a little bit of shadows, but it's kind of obvious they have, They could improve. There we go. Whatever. Bam.
I wonder if this key fits.
Big
There's
big
a key hidden inside. A very important one.
Dun-dun-dun.
Clara, it really is you. I was so certain I'd never see you again. You didn't wake up.
I woke up. I've been wandering lost ever since, trying to find out what's going on.
How are you feeling? Do you remember me?
I have no memories of you, or of myself. But I've found some notes lying around. I can only assume you're the one called Belladonna?
I am Belladonna. Murdered and reanimated by Dr. von Trauerschloss. At first, a mindless mechanical doll, but I slowly regained control over my brain. And when the time was right, I broke free.
I saw the doctor's body.
Yes, I crushed his skull. Standing over his blood-soaked remains, I was free at last.
But where did I come from? If he was dead, was it you who brought me back?
Yes, my love. You were the only thing on my mind as I stood there, alone and victorious. I'd secretly watched the doctor's process, and I desperately wanted to believe that I could get you back. I unearthed your grave and carried your dead body down to the laboratory. I did everything right, to the smallest detail, but you didn't wake up. And my time was running out. I can't turn my own key, and now that I was alone in the castle, I knew my life force would run out quickly. But for all my effort, you remained dead, and with no one to keep me vital, I eventually sat down here and just stopped.
But I did wake up.
Yes, apparently you did. Your body had been in the ground for quite some time. Perhaps that made the reanimation process slower. But with your key powering your brain directly, you did not have to go through the drawn-out, sluggish wake-up. I take it your cognitive powers and language have been with you from the start.
Well, yes.
Excellent. Then I have even improved on the doctor's method. But I doubt independent thinking and free will was ever in his interest to reproduce.
Do you think you could do it again?
Create more of us, you mean? Yes, I hold the secret of life and death, and I plan to use it. The experimentations must continue.
And the two of us will have no place in this world.
Quite right. So, we'll make us a place. Dead bodies will never be in short supply. We'll make more of our kind. A whole new race of the damned.
Where do we start?
I know for a fact that there's a fresh body lying out there in the Great Hall.
The doctor.
His flesh, at least. We won't be using his wretched brain. I've already destroyed it in any case. But the body will do. We will have to find a few other ingredients. Will you help me?
Of course I will.
Thank you, my love. I'll carry the body down to the laboratory and start with the preparations. And in the meantime, you can help me with a few other things. The doctor's brain is completely destroyed. I made sure of that. I don't think any of us want his villainous brain back amongst us. We're going to need to find a new one. Secondly, we will also need some clockwork parts. We have to manufacture a force to keep the dead body going. Thirdly, not only the brain, but also the head and the cranium were damaged. If we can find a new head, that would save a lot of reconstructing effort.
Okay.
I saw a brain preserved in alcohol down in the laboratory.
Oh, you did? That's good. That, my dear, is the brain of baby Lucas.
Your son?
Lucas was never buried. The doctor had the body cremated very quickly and thus incinerated all the evidence that the corpse was not complete. He'd stolen the brain and kept it for himself. I don't know what he claimed about not planning on resurrecting his child, but the truth is that he kept the brain all the same.
And now you want your child back?
No, my dear. It's just a brain. I wanted you back, so I took great care to preserve your personality. But this brain is young and has been dead for very long. I suppose the creation will be my child, in a way, but not my son Lucas.
Clockwork?
Yes, we need something to supply the body with the force to move. We can't make the heart beat again, so we use the spring-loaded clockwork. In the future, we'll have to think of a source of parts more reliable than salvaging old-time pieces, but that'll do for now.
All right, the grandfather clock in the main room there.
Thank you.
Will we need to find a fresh human head?
Yes, I've smashed up the head of Wolfram rather frivolously. I'm afraid it's beyond rescue. I was thinking of my grandmother, Francesca Canosa. I'm sure you've seen her portrait in the study. She was buried some time ago, but her cranium should be sufficiently preserved. She rests in the mausoleum in the cemetery outside, but there is a hidden way into the tomb behind the armor in the basement.
Okay.
Your grandmother, will it not cause problems to attach a woman's head to a man's body?
No, I don't see how it would make any difference in this new race of ours. We do not even reproduce sexually, so not even that significance is relevant.
What do you mean we don't reproduce sexually? How do you know?
I spent quite some time with Wolfram dead and mindless, you know. I can safely say that, though we do experience all the physical sensations of intercourse, we cannot become pregnant or bear children.
I see. I'll go take a look behind the suit of armor.
Thank you.
Some things have been puzzling me. Did I used to have hair?
You had beautiful hair. Unfortunately, I had to shave it all off in order to operate on your head and open your cranium.
Yet, you're not bald.
I was revivified directly after my death, when my body was still fresh. You, my dear, had been in the ground for quite some time. I had to reconstruct large parts of your decomposed corpse.
That explains the metal construction holding together my skull.
I have my fair share of screws and bolts myself, but they are carefully hidden. I opted to sacrifice your pretty hair so that I could work more on preserving your brain. Something the good doctor did not do for me.
Will it grow back?
Nope.
I don't rightly know. Maybe. We'll have to wait and see.
I want to ask something else.
I'm here for you.
What is this I'm wearing?
I'm so sorry about that. I covered you in scraps and bandages I found in the laboratory. I had to cut open and discard most of what you were buried in order to stitch you up. I want you to know that my plan was to be right next to you when you woke up, to help you understand and to find a proper dress. I'm so sorry it didn't come to pass like that.
On my way in here, I killed a cat. It was in my way and it felt so natural to just dispose of it. It worries me a bit.
How so?
I may have a functional brain, but what about a soul? Shouldn't there be something in me stopping me from hurting others? Or at least making me feel bad about it?
You're right. It did come very natural for me to murder my husband. But I'm not too worried about this. I have no desire to commit unnecessary killings, and I do have control over my actions.
What if you are raising an army of cold-hearted mass murderers?
What if you're raising an army of cold-hearted mass murderers?
They won't be mass murderers any more than you and I. And besides, why should we prioritize the lives of the living above the lives of the dead?
I want to ask something else.
I'm here for you.
Why did you put this wind-up mechanism in my head? Yours is in your back.
Yes, the damned doctor had placed my wind-up mechanism in my back. It goes straight into my chest and heart, giving me a strong central of power. But it is placed outside my own reach.
So, you can't turn it yourself?
No, I can't. I have to depend on others. That's why I chose to put the key in the back of your head, well within reach of your own hands. I know what it means to not be in control of your own existence, and I will never put someone else in the situation I'm in.
Thank you.
Of course.
I want to ask something else.
I'm here for you.
Back.
I'll start looking for the objects then.
Thank you. Come talk to me if there's something you're unsure about.
Sounded like she was winding down a little bit there.
That's a big wardrobe. Bet you could hide a corpse.
Alright, we're gonna need to hide a corpse in there at some point. Possibly ourselves. Clock.
I see a lot of mechanical parts in there. I need to get them out somehow.
Nope.
This faithful screwdriver will do the trick. Time to turn this old clock into a slightly peculiar wardrobe.
Okay. And now we need... Alright, so we have the brain. Now we need the... cranium.
Belladonna was right. There is a secret switch behind Roland the Poet. It's too dark down there. I won't see my hands in front of me unless I light the crypt up first.
Boop.
I can't just drop the lantern into the hole. It's gonna break when it hits the bottom. If there is a bottom.
Aha.
I'll just tie this rope to the lantern. Yes, I can lower the lantern into the hole.
There we go.
Amazing. I must be directly underneath the mausoleum and the cemetery.
By going straight down?
It's another letter. How did it end up down here?
Ooh. Da-doom. After insistent probing from my lady Belladonna, I too take to the pen. Come evening. The scribbling does not come as readily for me as it does for her, yet I do most certainly see the appeal in the activity. What? So much has happened in my life. Of late, my brain is overflowing with joy and secrets and disorder. If I managed to write down a map of a fraction of that, that would be an enormous relief. Kind of a weird font to read, or whatever. First time I saw her, standing next to her husband, blah blah blah. Time I finally recovered from her melancholy. That's how she finally recovered. Though seemingly everlasting, this bliss of ours, a seed of doubt is growing in my heart. Can I keep on living like this, or will I have to do the unthinkable and leave her? secrets upon secrets. Ronald the Bard. Shall hide this letter inside. Oh, okay, so it probably fell down through the armor.
Here's Francisca's coffin, but the lid is much too heavy for me to lift. Maybe I could break it open, but I'll need some sort of big hammer or mace for that.
Or a candlestick.
Things one does for love. You look very peaceful, but I do so need your head. How shall I remove it? With some surgical tool from the laboratory, perhaps?
Yep.
Another angel. Are you the third sibling? What did you do to get put down here? Is your name Gwendolyn? Now to carefully remove the head. It's remarkably well preserved.
Bam! Now there's a head. Alright, exit. Alright. Already carried the body down here. Let's get to work. We shall need the
body
brain.
Of a deranged murderer, the decomposed head of an old lady, the brain of a small child. How could this possibly go wrong?
Okay. I'll talk to her.
Welcome to the Lab of Horrors.
I have Francesca's head.
Well done. Just give it to me and I will attach it to the neck.
I took some parts from the old clock.
Well done. Let me put them into the creation.
I have the brain.
Well done. Please give it to me.
I found something else in the crypt. Another note. One I'd written myself when I was alive. I think we need to talk.
What is the matter, dear?
It's just... forget it. It doesn't matter. Let's focus on what we're doing here.
Yes, let's get this creation moving.
I'll get going. I'll let Belladonna handle that.
Well, it's still in my inventory.
Thank you.
You look so lonely, my friend. I'll call you Eva.
Okay.
Thank you, dear. Thank you, dear. The creation is complete. All we need to do now is force life into these dead limbs. That big switch on the wall initiates the procedure. Will you have the honor, my dear?
Gladly.
Bam!
Time has come. I've wanted to pull this thing since the first time I saw it.
Censor that for the YouTube, but whatever. Okay, so test Bane's dissolved voices, I guess. Okay, so that was Belladonna. Alright, yeah, not that long, but kind of interesting. Interesting story. It's as long as it needed to be. I think I missed one of the journal pages somewhere, so I don't think I'm actually going to go back and hunt down that last one, just for completionism's sake. Maybe you get a different ending or something if you do that, but yeah, there you go. Belladonna. Till next time, Lita.